Matt? Oh my God, you're here? What?
It's Halloween. I got us VIP passes to Hellfest.
What is that?
It's a traveling horror night. Has horror mazes in it. You will totally lose it in there.
Yeah. It's gonna be fun, right?
Why are we signing a waiver?
Well, because the liability is, hey, bitch. A couple years ago, some girl got totally gutted.
Killer left her body in the park for 3 days. They thought she was a freaking prop.
Some people are just evil.
They walk among us.
Shut up!
Yes, we get it.
You think you're scaring me?
No.
Move.
Look, the more scared you seem, the more they're gonna come after you. You have to just play it cool.
Help me! Please help me!
You can just do it.
That was insane, right?
Ooh.
Yeah, real.
The same guy's been following us the entire night.
You take your job too seriously.
This really isn't funny, dude.
Be scared, right? I can't arrest people for doing their job. Welcome to Hellfest.
Hello? Hey, can you let me out of here?
It's Savannah Jason, and it's time to talk about the one, the only Fear Fest. Wait, that's wrong. Hellfest. Released in 2018, Hellfest is one of them kind of movies that you would love to pop in on a Friday night when you got nothing better to do but to smoke a blunt, drink a beer, and hang out with your friends, and, you know, just do random shit. But, I mean, it's a good popcorn flick, you know. You would definitely have a good time watching this shit. A lot of people have been saying that it's boring and it's not that entertaining because it's kind of a one-and-done kind of film, you know. It doesn't really have a building up to a great plot, you know. You don't really go to a movie like Hellfest for the plot, though. You go for the scares and the comedy in it because it does got some great comedy. You know, it's got a lot of good action and good kills. So right away, I'm going to get into my likes and, if I can think of any, my fucking dislikes. But first, I'm going to need another drink of this beer. Alright, so right away, the movie opens up action-packed because it opens up with a girl at the theme park, Hellfest, because it says a traveling horror show that goes from town to town. And you're seeing where this girl is walking around in Hellfest, and this guy is stalking her, chasing her through the mazes. And the dude actually fucking kills her, like for real. You know, there's no acting bullshit going on in this theme park. This guy's actually a weirdo and a psycho. He had put on a mask. And he goes and follows this traveling horror show to each location they go to and kills somebody at random. He has no motive. He has no reasoning. He's kind of like Michael Myers, you know. That's the only negative I could think of because this guy is like a stock version of Myers. He doesn't really, you know, give you much. There's no vocalization. He's just a brute force that's there to fuck people up, especially teenagers. That's what he focuses on. And young girls and young guys that are drunk as shit and shit-faced at Hellfest. So he kills the girl and props her up as if one of the dummies that are at these theme parks, you know. So nobody thinks otherwise. And then we fast forward a few months later, and we're introduced to the character Natalie and her friend Brooke. And Natalie is coming back home from being at college for a long time. And her best friend Brooke is going to introduce her to the theme park that is Hellfest. And they get together with a couple of other friends. One girl in particular, Taylor, played by Bex Taylor. what's her name?
Klaus.
Yeah, Bex Taylor Klaus. She's pretty awesome in this. She's fucking badass. She's phenomenal. I actually liked her in this a lot. A lot of people don't give her the credit she deserves in this because she's funny as fuck. She's like the one that brings the humor in this. She's, of course, gorgeous as always. As you know her from the Scream MTV series, she's pretty damn hilarious in this and a main focal point of the comedy. But, yeah, the killer in this, he's all right, you know. And then once you get into the main Hellfest theme part, where all of them show up to go there and have fun and have a damn good time, the action picks up and it doesn't stop from there on out. So, yeah, pretty much my likes would be the kills. There are some very creative and inventive kills in this. He actually takes a big-ass mallet and slams it over and bashes his dude fucking brains out. And the gore in it's pretty damn good, pretty decent for a pretty much a throwback 90s slasher flick, you know, is what Hellfest basically is. And the ending of the movie, however, is kind of weird and creepy as shit. And it leaves you on kind of a cliffhanger. You don't know if they're going to make a second one. Maybe they will, maybe they won't. But the killer, like I said, has been going and following this place to every location they go to. And he actually has a collection of masks that he has wore. And every time he has went and struck at this place. So the ending will throw you for a loop. It's kind of fucking crazy. But this movie overall is just a good time, good popcorn flick that you watch just for the hell of it. Pun intended. So I'm going to go ahead and give Hellfest a 10 out of 10. Because it is just that damn good. So anyways, it's been me, Savini Jason. And I'm going to get out of here, but I had to get on here and talk about this crazy-ass fucking movie. Go out and buy it.